Ang issue ko dyan kasi with some brokers and agents, not all, in the desire to sell the property, they sort of cover up the not so desirable traits and even, you know, justify these things. In my heart, in my opinion, dapat when you're selling a property, the buyer should be eyes open with everything. The good, the bad, and the ugly. Hi guys! Realtor Mike here. In this episode, we'll share with you tips on how to choose a property. We'll focus it on the residential property, whether for end use, gusto nyong tiran, or for investment. And I'm tackling this topic since I've had two clients who wanted to unload their property, mga investment to. But we are having some difficulty since merong konting defects yung property. Let's say, undesirable traits, which turns off some buyers since there are a lot of properties being sold in that particular village. They're not into the priority list of the buyers. So if you want these properties to be sold, it must be sold at a discount. Ang issue ko dyan kasi with some brokers and agents, not all, in the desire to sell the property, they sort of cover up the not so desirable traits and even, you know, justify these things. In my heart, in my opinion, dapat when you're selling a property, the buyer should be eyes open with everything. The good, the bad, and the ugly. Yung magandang traits of the property, the not so good traits, everything else in between. So that in the future, when their buyer decides to unload, to sell, it's hindi surprising. Itong dalawang clients ko were really surprised by it, no? Because their agent apparently told them, no, it's okay, those traits are overshadowed by so-and-so, ganyan. So that's my appeal to my fellow brokers and the agents, especially the young ones. So you just tell everything, and they will appreciate you for that, being honest. You may not get the sale, but babalikan ka. Your reputation will be intact. Unlike those two, the owners are saying bad things about the agent na bakit ganito, why did they sell me something like this, that I'm stuck with this. Yun, okay, so let's go through the list. I've divided it into the desirables and the undesirables. The number one desirable trait, it's a corner lot. Many prefer this, and the developers know this. That's why they put in 500 peso to 2,000 peso per square meter premium on corner lots. Bakit siya maganda? Because of aesthetic, you have two faces of the property. One warning lang with the corner lots, it may eat up some of your lot, no? Since ang requirement ng mga villages is to have more setbacks, anything fronting the streets. Yun, so corner lot. Number two, yung orientation. The east facing is the most desired, generally, because of the morning sun. So maganda sa umaga, normally the master bedroom is situated in front of the property, facing there, and the living area. So it is very nice that in the morning, the master bedroom, yun, nasisikata ng araw, and the morning sun is really nice. And the afternoon, medyo mainit. So if it's the other way around, yung west, but of course, the architects can overcome these challenges, no? Because not every property is east-facing. I have a west-facing property, eh, so may konting remedials, no? Sa feng shui naman, no? They say it's east, but generally, as I've been encountering my Filipino-Chinese clients, it depends on their birthday. Yung kanilang orientation, the south is luckier than the west, and so on and so forth. So, another desirable trait is near the facility, no? Yung clubhouse, swimming pool, basketball court. Many of my clients desire properties that are near to the facilities but not so near. That's something very interesting. Not so near means a street or two streets away para may buffer for the noise that it may cause. But generally, of course, they want it somewhere near the facilities. Another desirable is a regular shape of the property. So rectangular or squarish. But generally, mas okay, mas binibili or mas attractive yung regular shape versus the irregular shape. So minsan, there are some irregular shape properties that they have very small frontages and very wide sa sides. Yung prosperity daw will have a difficult time going out. So it's a lucky shape. So iba-iba talaga, no? The most desirable is the one that has rectangular siya, pero the frontage is wider than the sides. Yan. So, undesirable since that they call it medaya in terms of design because the house will look bigger than it actually is. So, because mahaba or the frontage, the vista, the front of the house will be wider, okay, than if it were the other way around na mas maliit yung frontage on the sides. Yun ang general terms. So, general, ano lang naman yan. Again, good architects can overcome these irregular shaped challenges. Another desirable is the elevation. Yan. So the higher it is, better views, the more desirable. But there's again a warning to that, no? The construction cost may be higher. The lot is higher, no? Tapos we can see that in, let's say, Ayala West Grove in Ayala Heights, no? Mataas nga siya, but at the back, the property is high. The positive of that is that they can make 4 or 5 levels, no? Pero yung construction cost yan, yung excavation pa lang, is really very high. Yun. So yun ang trade-offs niyan, okay? So walang perfect, but there are trade-offs with that elevation thing. So let's go naman to the not so desirable, no? After going to the desirables, one of the problem of the one of the lots that I mentioned earlier, no, it's a tumbok lot. Tumbok, they have different terms, no? T lot, letter T, merong key lot, they call it, no? So essentially, what is a tumbok lot? The tumbok lot is that the street, when you go straight, it hits that particular lot. Okay, it has, for me, it had a practical reason before why it is, they say, not so lucky or malas, or, but I really don't believe in that. May practical history ang tingin ko, no? So, when, for example, there's a truck that loses their brakes, ang unang tatamaan sa street na yun is the tumbok lot. So, it's a practical scenario which has evolved into a spiritual thing na malas daw and so on and so forth. Since I don't believe that, but in terms of reselling, nagkakaproblema yan. And if we will go through the priority selling, those lots are the ones that are left behind. One thing about the agents, they do not relay that, no? To some unsuspecting people na, you know, they're not really used to this, they do not disclose that. Pero dapat full disclosure yon na, sir, it may have problems in the future or some people like it, but it has to be disclosed. One short story, no, I'll share with you regarding this tumbok lot. No, positive naman, no? I had a co-broker, si Mr. Aquino of Quezon City. So he had a big lot in Ayala Heights, so 2,000 square meters or 1,000 square meters. And it was a tumbok lot. So there were viewings, no? Took pre-qualified the agents or the buyers. It said it's a tumbok lot. Many inquiries would decline the viewing. Ah, I don't like the tumbok lot. But there's a client, no, that went to the lot. He said it was tumbok. When he went up the road and saw the lot, he said, perfect, that's the lot that I want. So he sold it. He was able to sell it. Many people believe, but there are some people who don't believe in these things. If you're a one-time lot buyer, I would dissuade you from buying such properties. But there are investors, they look for tumbok lots for a discount. And they don't care about those things. Basta they can get value over it. Less than, let's say, 5 to 20% of the market price they would buy. The next not so desirable is that the property is near the MRF. What is the MRF? MRF is the Materials Recovery Facility. Or where they put the trash. Yan. So MRF. Okay, so you look at the map. So yung MRF. Yung STP, Sewage Treatment Plant. So STP. Okay. Another is the water tank. Some buyers will not take your property if you plan to resell it. No? So those things are put in the maps, but sometimes they're not familiar with those terms. Just go over it and they do not really mind these things. Pero sa actual yan, ideally, yung STP should work like no odors yan, no smell, no anything. But sometimes it has their problems. Minsan, meron yan. Just like the MRF. Okay, so as much as possible, avoid those areas na malapit. So stay away. The last not so desirable is about the perimeter fence of a village. The closer you are to the perimeter, the less desirable it is. Yan. Because of security, because of noise, and because of other factors. As much as possible, try to get properties not beside the perimeter, somewhere near the middle of the community. As much as possible. So all these things, yung desirables and not desirables, are not absolutes. You may still have a beautiful property even if it's a T-lot, near the perimeter, on the perimeter, or irregular cut. There's a counter to everything. There's a remedial measure to everything. These are just general guidelines that you may want to consider when choosing a property. So yun muna. So let me know below if you have other desirables and not desirables that I may have missed. Again, this is Realtor Mike saying stay safe and stay in faith. God bless. Bye.